So this video will show you the easiest method to get the VP9 codec on your video. I have three examples here. This video has VP9, this video has VP9, and this video doesn't. You can see it's MP4A and AVC. This is VP9 and Opus. And that has different reasons. This video has VP9 because it's in 4K. And everything higher than 2K, like 2K, 4K, 8K, has VP9 automatically. So you don't have to do anything if you're uploading at 2K or more. This video was one where I did a method to, because you can see this has not 2K or 4K. And this one has the same, is not 2K or 4K, and I didn't do anything to it. So let's try and get VP9 on this video, which you can clearly see hasn't got VP9 yet. You just click on edit, then on enhancements, and then you have a few options here. The easiest way is to do this. You click on trim, then in this screen you just pull this to the right and back, or this to the left and back. It depends what you want, it doesn't matter. And then you click on this arrow to the right or this arrow to the left one time to go one frame. Then you will cut out one frame of the video. One frame of the video won't make any difference in most cases. But if it does make a difference, you can choose whether you want to cut one frame from the beginning or the end. I will just cut one frame from the beginning. You can see it on the timeline because one frame is less than 0.0 seconds in a 60 FPS video. But you can see, if you are not one frame away, then you can not clear what you did. But if you are one frame away, you can clear. You can undo everything that you did. So you will cut only this tiny bit and then click on done. Then you have to click on save. You can't click on save as new video. You have to click on save and replace the video you got. Then you will be brought back to this screen and you can see edit in progress. This will take a few hours, maybe a day, maybe 2 days, depending on the length of your video and stuff like the resolution and stuff. So give it some time. But now to the other stuff that you could have done to this video. Okay, to try out a different method, I will just use this video because I can't get into enhancements while it's progressing. So you just get into enhancements again. And if you don't want to trim the video, but I don't know why you wouldn't want to trim one frame of it, you could use anything from here. You could use a filter, but I don't know why you would. Like, you could make it look like this, which would be weird. Blurring effects like face blurring and custom blurring, but I don't know why you would do that. You can use stuff like this, like change the saturation to max or to lowest, which would make sense. The only thing that would make sense would be to change the saturation or the light or the contrast or something by only one. Like, make it one more or one less. That you can do that. Like, I will do the saturation plus one for this test, and then click on save again, and this will do the same thing, but this will change the video more. You will notice the change in the video. So the method with the one frame edit will be the better method, because you won't change anything of the video. I will see you tomorrow again when this both is edited, and then I will show you that this codec change is happening and that it happened. So see you tomorrow. So we are now 20 hours in the future. This is still the same video, as you can see. And now if you right click and then click on Stats for Nerds, it says VP9 and Opus, or I don't know how you would call that. Yeah, and our other example, as you can see, is VP9 and Opus as well. So at least if you change something, anything, it doesn't have to be a big thing in the enhancements tab. Your video will become VP9, but you will have to wait a long time. I tried this with another video, and a few hours after I was finished, the edit in progress, banner was gone, but it was still MP4, and then I waited a day, so like 20 hours, 24 hours again, and then it was VP9. So you really have to wait a long time even after the edit in progress banner is gone. Just because it's gone doesn't mean it's finished. So yeah, just keep that in mind. If you see the edit in progress banner is gone and you click on the video and it's still MP4, just wait a few more hours. Give it a day, maybe 2 days, and if it's not changed in 2 days, then try another method. So that's it for the tutorial. If you have any questions, just leave it in the comment section below. And if something changes, I will post that in a comment to this video. So yeah, have fun and goodbye.